Good morning student. Today I am going to solve the numerical from NCERT book which is based on topic current electricity. And first question, student, listen carefully. The storage battery of a car has an EMF of 12 volt. If the internal resistance of the battery is 0.4 ohm, what is the maximum current that can be drawn from the battery? So student, maximum current can be drawn from a battery in this case, external resistance must be what? Zero. Then I becomes maximum, and you know the formula I equal to what? E by R plus R. So we know that question number first, we know that current drawn from the cell I equal to what? E by R plus R. When R equal to what? Zero. So when R, that is what? Zero. External resistance, that is what? Zero. I becomes, that is what? Maximum. So I becomes maximum when external resistance, that is what? Zero. So formula comes out to be that I max equal to E by R. And EMF of the cell which is given 12 volt student, and internal resistance which is 4 ohm. Solving this, 120 by 4, and it comes out to be that what? 30. So current maximum comes out to be that 30 ampere, and this is the required answer for question number first. Question number two, student, listen carefully. A battery of EMF 10 volt and internal resistance 3 ohm is connected to a resistor. If the current in the circuit is 0.5 ampere, what is the resistance of the resistor and what is the terminal voltage of the battery when the circuit is closed? So student, we have to find the external resistance R and potential terminal potential difference also across R. So we know the I equal to what? E by R plus R. So from this formula we can find capital R. And then we use the formula V equal to IR, and putting the value of I and R, we can get the required result. So in case of the second case, what quantity is given? Student, see carefully. Question number two, given value, that is what? Given value is, that is what? EMF of the cell, which is what? 10 volt. And internal resistance R, that is what? 3 ohm. And if the current flowing through this cell, that is what? 0.5 ampere. And we have to find external resistance and we have to find what? Terminal voltage. So student, already you know that current drawn from the cell, that is I equal to what? E by R plus R. And here I, that is what? 0.5 student, and E, that is what? 10 volt. R we have to find, and small r student, you know that is what? 3. Cross multiplication, that is what? 0.5 R plus 1.5, which is equal to 10, and transferring 0.5 R, which is equal to 10 minus 1.5, and it comes out to be that 8.5 student. So 0.5 R, which is equal to 8.5. So R equal to, comes out to be that 8.5 by 0.5, and 8 5, this point cancel out student, so it comes out to be that 85 by 5. 5 1 5 3 5 7. So R comes out to be that what? 17 ohm. And this is the external resistance, R equal to 17 ohm. And we have to find terminal potential difference. And terminal potential difference, V equal to what? IR. And I, that is what? Which is given 0.5 student. And R we have find already 17. 8.5 volt. So terminal potential comes out to be that 8.5 volt. This is the actual answer of R which is 17 ohm and V that is what 8.5 volt. Question number 3, student, listen carefully. Three resistors 1 ohm, 2 ohm and 3 ohm are connected in series. What is the total resistance of the combination? So student, you know that in series combination R equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. B part, if the combination is connected to a battery of EMF 12 volt and negligible internal resistance, obtain the potential drop across the each resistor. So first of all, in series combination, three resistance whose value 1 ohm, 2 ohm, 3 ohm are given, which are connected in series. And in series combination, that is what? Resistance will be added. And you know that in series combination, current across each resistance, that is what? Same. But potential difference across each resistance, that is what? Different. So first of all, we find the equivalent resistance, find the total current, and then we find the potential drop across R1, R2, R3, so on in this way. So first of all, student, question number 3, R1, R2 and R3, which is given, which is connected in what? Series. So first of all, given quantity, suppose R1 that is what? R1 that is 1 ohm, R2 that is what? 2 ohm. And R3 that is what? R3 that is what? 3 ohm. And EMF of the cell which is also given. And E equal to what? 12 volt. And student, we have to find total resistance in series combination. So you know that R equivalent. RS means total equivalent resistance in series combination. RS equal to what? R1 plus R2 plus R3, and it is given that is what? R1 that is what? 1 plus 2 plus what? 3, and it comes out to be what? 6 ohm. You know that, very easy question. And we have E is given, R equivalent resistance is given, and internal resistance that is what in this question? Negligible internal resistance. It means what? First we have found the current through circuit, current I equal to what? E by R plus R, but here small r, that is what? Negligible, so we can write that is what? R plus 0. So current through the circuit E by R, and E which is given, that is what? 12 ohm. And R equivalent, here R equivalent, RS which is given, RS this one, and this one RS, and it is what? 6 ohm. 6 to jar, that is what? So current I comes out to be that 2 ampere. So total current which comes out to be that 2 ampere, and in series combination current across R1, R2, R3, that is what? Same. So but potential drop, that is what? Different. So potential drop PD, potential difference across R1 means what? V1 equal to what? I R1, because I is same in series combination. So I that is what? 2. R1 that is what? 1. That is what? 2 volt. V2, similarly, potential drop or potential difference across R2, which is comes out to be that is what? I R2. And I that is what? 2. And R2 that is what? 2, which comes out to be what? 4 volt. This is the answer. Potential drop, similarly V1, V2, potential drop across what? R3. Again I R3, because in series combination current is what? Same. 2 into R3, that is what? 3. So V3 comes out to be that is what? 6 volt. So student, potential drop across R1, 2 volt. Potential drop across R2, that is what? 4 volt. Potential drop across R3, that is what? 6 volt. And total current through a circuit, that is what? 2 ampere. And total current, total resistance in series combination already calculated, which is known as what? That is 6 ohm. This is the answer. Next question, student. Question number 5. 4 easy question. You can try and solve it. Question number 5. at room temperature 27 degree centigrade, the resistance of a heating element is 100 ohm. What is the temperature of the element if the resistance is found to be 117 ohm, given that temperature coefficient of material of the resistor is 1.70 into 10 to the power minus 4 per degree centigrade. So student, you know the formula. I have already explained to you that in this chapter, when temperature increases, resistance of the metallic conductor, that is what? Increases. So question number 5, and we know the formula, that is what? RT equal to R0 1 plus alpha delta T. Delta T means what? Change in temperature, T2 minus T1 or T minus T0. So using this formula, we have to find the temperature when the resistance is what? 117 ohm. And student, here we use this formula, and given at room temperature, suppose that 27 degree, that resistance of the heating element is 100 ohm. Suppose R1, that is what? R1, that is given 100 ohm, and temperature, that is what? T1, which is given 27 degree centigrade, student. And R2, that is what? 117 ohm, which is given, and we have to find T2. Here we have to find alpha, temperature coefficient of resistance, which is given, alpha, that is what given, and its value, that is what? 1.70 into 10 to the power minus 4 degree centigrade minus 1. And student, we use this formula. Here R0 taken, that is what? R1, RT taken to be what? R2, and delta T, which is what? T2 minus T1. So we use the formula here in this way. Using formula here, R2, that is what? R1 in place of R0, that is what? R1 in place of RT. R2 1 plus alpha delta T, that is what? Delta T can be written as T2 minus T1, change in temperature, rise in temperature. R2 student, which is given 117. R1, that is what? 100. 1 plus alpha student, T alpha, its value is also given, that is what? 1.70 into 10 to the power minus 4. And T2 we have to find, and T1, that is what? 27 degree centigrade. Student, now we transferring this, when multiply by this and this, multiply by this, and transferring to the left side, it comes out to be that 117, and when it comes out to be what? 100. This will be what? 100. And also it can also be written as a student, that is what? By simplification, we can this 100 into 1.7 into 10 to the power minus 4, that is what? 100. When 100 comes out to be that 117 minus 100 into 100, and this 100 and 1.7 10 to the power minus 4 comes out to be denominator, and here that is what? T2 minus 27. And student, when it will be 117 minus 100, that is what? 70. Clear? Here 70 comes out to be that. And student, 1.7, when it comes out to be that what? 10 to the power minus 5, 10 to the power minus 5, considering 20, and it comes out to be what? 10 to the power what? Minus 3. 10 to the power minus 4, 10 to the power minus 1, 10 to the power minus 5, or 10 to the power minus 5, 10 to the power 2, it comes out to be 10 to the power minus 3. Here 17 by 17 cancel out, when it moves in here T2 minus 27, when denominator 10 to the power moves to the numerator, student, it comes out to be what? 10,000. 10 to the power 3 means what? Positive in numerator, and it comes out to be student T2 minus 27. When it comes out to be in this, so T2 can be written as 100 plus 27. So temperature comes out to be that 1027 degree centigrade, and student, and this is the answer for resistance. When temperature rises, whose temperature when resistance becomes 117 ohm, which is 1027 degree centigrade. Next question, circuit diagram is given and we have to determine the current in each branch. In this circuit, we have to determine the current in each branch. Current in each branch, that is in AB, BC, CD and AD. So first of all, student, we have to show the distribution of current. Suppose that this cell send a current into the circuit, that is what? I. This I current, and it divided into I1 and I2. This current divided into I1 and I2. And when this I1 current reaches to here, student, this I1 break into suppose that I3. In the middle arm, that is what? Current I3 flow, and from I1, I3 flow through this. So rest of the current in this circuit, that is what? I1 minus I3. Rest of the current in this arm, that is what? I1 minus I3, and this is the I1, I3, and this is 5 ohm resistance is here. And when I3 comes to here, I2 comes to here, in this branch, I2 plus I3 current flowing in this branch, student. I2 plus I3 in this, and again when it comes to here, I3 cancel out, here comes up to be what? I1 plus and I2, and which is equal to what? I. So there will be distribution of current. See carefully. Battery send the current I. This I current reaches to A at junction law takes place. This I1 part of this I move to arm AB, and I2 move to AD. And this I1 when comes to at B, I3 current flow through the middle arm 5 ohm, and I1 minus I3 ohm current, I1 minus I3 current flow through the arm BC, and this resistance, that is what? 5 ohm. And when at C, this current coming from I3 to here and I2, that is what? Again, junction law takes place. In this arm DC current flowing through, that is what? I2 plus I3. And this current when reaches at C, again junction law takes place, I3 minus I3, cancel out I1 plus I2 again. So current entering into the circuit, which is current leaving the circuit, here I, which is equal to what? I1 plus I2, so I1 plus I2 becomes what? I. Now student, we have to find I1, I2 and I3. So first of all, we apply Kirchhoff loop law 2. Apply Kirchhoff loop law 2, R A B D A, A B D A. Apply Kirchhoff loop law 2, R A B D A. So path we have chosen A B D A, and direction of the current is also in same direction. So here product of resistance and current, that is what? Positive. So here we written as 10 I1. Here current and resistance product, which is also what? Positive, because path and the direction of the current. Here direction of the traverser is opposite to the direction of what? Current. So here product of current and resistance, that is what? Negative. So 5 I2, that is what? 0. And this is equation, student, that is what? 1. Now apply Kirchhoff loop law to B D C B. In loop B D C B, apply Kirchhoff loop law. direction of the current and direction of the traverser, that is what, same positive current and current and resistance, their product positive, current and resistance, their product, that is what, positive, but here that is what, negative. So first of all we have to write 5i3 plus 10i2 plus i3, both are positive, and when it moves from in this direction, the traverser and the direction of the current is what, opposite. So here minus 5 can be written as i1 minus i3, which is equal to what, 0. Student, no cell in this loop and no cell in this loop, so EMF, that is what, 0. Solving this, see here, minus 5, so it can be written as, first minus 5 i1, minus 5 i1, that is what, this one, i2, 10 i2 plus 10 i2 plus 10 i2 as it is. So number of 5 i3 plus 10 i3, 15 i3, 15 i3 and plus 5 i3, that is what, 20 i3. So it can be written as 20 i3, and this is equation, that is what, 2. Minus 5i1, clear, 10i2, clear, 5i3 and 10i3, 15i3 and minus minus, that is what, plus 20i3, this is equation 2. Now we apply Kirchhoff loop law in loop A, D, C, suppose that this is point 1, A, D, and we have taken here, that is what, E point. Suppose that A, D, C, E, A, loop, apply Kirchhoff loop, in loop A, D, C, E, A, D, C, A, apply Kirchhoff loop law, apply same Kirchhoff loop law, same as it is in previous case. So that is what, path, current and resistance positive, current and resistance positive, current and resistance, that is what, positive, but here I will take I1 plus I2. So here resistance current 5i2, clear, next 10, current, that is what, I2 plus I3, in this 10 resistance, current, that is what, we have to write here I, but I which is what, I1 plus I2, so 10 I1 plus I2, and there will be a cell whose EMF, that is what, we are traveling from negative terminal to the positive terminal of the cell, so here potential difference or EMF taken to be what, positive, and it will be what, 10, student. Now first we write I1, 10 I1, no I1 here, 10 I1, clear, 5i2, 10i2, 15i2 and 10i2, 25i2, 5i2, 10i2, 15i2, 15i2 and 10i2, 25i2. Now i3, 10i3, only 10i3, 10i3 which is equal to what, 10, 5i1, 10i1, 5i2, 15, 15 and 10, 25i3, only that will be 10i3, and this is equation, that is what, 3. And from equation 1, 2 and 3, first of all we have to eliminate in 3 quantity, I1, I2, I2, first we have to eliminate one of them. So first we have to eliminate here from equation 1 and 2, 10i1, 10i1. So first we eliminate I1 from first and second. So equation 1 minus, what? Equation 3. So we have to write, that is what? Student, 10i1, listen carefully, plus 5i3 minus 5i2, that is what? 0. Here 10i1 plus 25i2 plus 10 I3 which is equal to what? 10. We have to what? Minus. So this will what? Cancel out to student and it comes out to here. Minus here first. Minus 25 I2 minus 5 I2. It means what? It comes out to be that minus 30 I2. And this 30 I2 comes out to be student 30 I2, and this one is a minus 30 I2 minus 5 I3, and this is what? Minus 10. If you divide with minus I and also with what? 5 divided, and it comes out to be student. This comes out to be that here. After minus dividing, 5 dividing, so that will be what? 6 I2. Here comes out to be that plus I3, which is equal to what? Plus 2, and this is equation 4, student. 5 6 are 30, 6 I2, 5 1 are 5 1, and that is what? 2. And after this comes out to be minus, this comes out to be minus 30 minus, okay, this is equation 4. Now we have to eliminate same quantity I1 from what? From 1 and 2. See here, from 2 and 3. From 2 and 3, add 2 into equation what? 2 plus equation what? 3. 2, multiply this equation by 2 and add by what? 3. So it comes out to student minus 10 I1. Minus 10 I1 plus, when multiplied by 2, it comes out to be what? 20 I2. It comes out to 20, and this comes out to be what? 40 I3. 40 I3, and student here, that is what? 0. And equation 3 as it is, that is what? 10 I1 plus 25 I2 plus 10 I3 equal to what? 10. And student, this will be what? This is plus 10 I1, not minus 10 I1. So this will what? Cancel out. 45 I2 plus 50 I3, that is what? 10. Equation, that is, this is equation, that is what? 25, 10, that is, this is equation 5. Now student, with the help of what? 4 and 5, we have to eliminate what? Anyone? So this one can be eliminated. Here 50, here only I3. So multiply equation 4 by what? 50, and then what? 4 minus 5. So 50 into equation 4 minus equation what? Equation 5. It comes out to be written as, say, 300 I2 plus 50 I3 multiplied by 50 equation 4. And that is what? 100 student. And here, as it is, 45 I2 plus 50 I3, that is what? As it is, 10. And minus, cancel out to student, and it comes out to be, that is what? 255 I2. And here comes out to be, that is what? 90 student. So I think you know all these things here, and we now delete this figure for solving the rest of the value. So student, see carefully, 255. So I2 comes out to be, that is what? I2 comes out to be that what? 90 by 255 and 5 1 ja 8 ja and 3 6 ja 3 3 1 ja 3 3 7 ja and 3 6 ja. So student, I2 comes out to be that what? 6 by 17 ampere. I2 comes out to be 6 by 17 ampere, and put this value in equation this 4 from 1 from 4. Now we remove this all quantity. Student, I2 comes out to be that we have to use this equation in last. So when I2 comes up from equation, what? Put the value of I2 in from equation 4. Student, see carefully. 6 into I2 comes out to be what? 6 by 17 plus I3, which is equal to what? 2. And student, see carefully, when it moves other 36 by what? 17. And when 17 minus, it comes out to be 34 minus 2 by 17 ampere. So I3 comes out to be student what? I3 equal to minus 2 by 17 ampere. Now put this value in equation 1. I2 calculated, I3 calculated, and we have to find what? I1. So from equation 1, from equation 1, 10 I1 as it is plus 5 I3, that is what? Minus 2 by what? 17, and minus 5 into I2, that is what? 6 by 17, and that is what? 0. Students, see carefully. 10 I1 plus minus 10 by 17 minus 30 by 17, and student, it is 0. And solving this, 10 I1, it comes out to, when it takes in other side, so it comes out to be what? 10 by 17 plus 30 by 17, LCM, that is what?